You know, I think whatever works for them, they stick with. Other games, it's their full court pressure, pressuring people in the backcourt. As you mentioned, we broke that, and then they, you know, they have length. They have length and athleticism, and we had trouble getting the balls to the corner. Probably right. The most we've seen a 1-3-1 for extended periods. Normally, yeah, you make a couple shots, you can get a team out of it, and I thought they, you know, were pretty good just sticking with it, and obviously they rebounded the ball. We didn't get to the foul line, which that's what a zone will do. Yes. You force you to shoot some jump shots, and we had trouble getting the ball to the corner to Adonis, who's a good shooter. Overall, I thought they always kept a soft balance on both ends of the court. At times, Malcolm's a facilitator, our best defensive player, and today was a scoring punch. And, you know, going into the game, we just talked about their pressure and how they're just going to try to make us play at a pace we're uncomfortable with, and I thought Malcolm did a good job of just really handling, settling us. We had 11 turnovers in the first half, 6 for the second half, but still they rattled us. But individually, Malcolm was probably his best statistical game in his career. Quinnipiac struggled, but they're like, you know, as a kid like Julian Norfleet, Quinnipiac's a team that's probably better than their record right. For sure. And it's going to take a game or two for them to all of a sudden go on a run. And they have a dominant inside presence, and they can really get you on the backboards. And whenever that's the case, and then they make a lot of free throws, whenever that's the case, they're going to be in every ball game. So we have to match their intensity on the backboards, and we have picked up our rebounding. Brandon Peel got 11 tonight. So we've struggled versus Quinnipiac past couple games, and hopefully we'll be prepared to play them.